second COVID-19 vaccine in Russia completed phase 2 clinical trials. In Russia, another vaccine candidate for COVID-19 successfully wrapped up its early-stage clinical trials. The second vaccine is developed by the Vector Institute. The State Consumer Safety Watchdog confirmed the success of phase 2 clinical trials. The clinical study began in July and a total of 100 participants were involved, according to Reuters. The vaccine candidate is based on peptide shots. The method is not new in vaccine development and disease prevention. In this method, drug makers usually include 20 to 30 amino acids that contain the specific epitope of an antigen, which is related to the pathogen. The second Russian COVID-19 vaccine may contain the proteins from the antigen of SARS-CoV-2. All 100 participants in the trial were administered with 2 doses. They were monitored for 23 days in the hospital. The final 20 participants were recently released from the hospital. Although side effects were not yet unveiled, participants reported feeling good after the study. The use of peptides is an alternative technique in treating or preventing diseases. The technique has been applied before to develop therapeutic anti-cancer vaccines. It is also the focus of some vaccines for HIV, hepatitis, malaria, influenza, and anthrax. However, these vaccines are still being developed. According to the WHO, peptide vaccines have unique advantages compared to existing vaccines, such as the inactivated and attenuated variants. First, peptide vaccines are all synthetic versions of the original antigen peptides. This removes the possibility of mutation or reversion and lowers contamination by pathogens or toxic substances. Second, synthetic peptides can be manipulated by vaccine makers. They can increase the stability and decrease undesirable side effects. And third, the peptides can be configured or optimized. Vaccine makers can make peptides unseen by the immune system detectable. Unfortunately, there are challenges in creating peptide vaccines that hamper deployment in markets. The most common challenge is figuring out the peptide sequences. At a glance, the sequences appear to be simple, but antigens are typically composed of different parts of the protein sequence. These parts come together and form a three-dimensional structure. Biomedical scientists have to model these structures and determine which peptides are related to the antigen. This delicate process is required to know the correct antigenic site. If the antigenic site is incorrect, the vaccine will not work at best. At worst, unwanted side effects may occur.